Hello and welcome to Reality Check. An escalating controversy has broken out over new rules by the center, which give the BSF a greater footprint in the state of Punjab. The rules were not just limited to Punjab, but was redefining the BSP's reach in other border states as well. The center says to fight effectively the drug menace and the menace of terrorism. So the BSF's areas have been redefined in border states across the board. In Punjab, West Bengal and Assam, the area of the BSF's footprint has increased from 15 kilometers to 50 kilometers from the border. In Gujarat, the area has reduced from 80 kilometers to 50 kilometers from the border. The BSF's areas remain the same for Rajasthan and other states. No additional powers of arrest and so on have been given to the BSF, contrary to some media reports. The powers of arrest, search, under central laws already existed. So why has this triggered such a major controversy in Punjab? Well, for one, Punjab is smaller than other border states like Rajasthan, Gujarat and so on. That's one of the reasons. The 50 kilometers from the border brings the BSF's powers into the heart of Punjab, which is a proxy, some say, for extending central control of a non-BJP state. Key towns like Amritsar and Pathankot will come under the BSF jurisdiction, sparking turf wars between Punjab police and BSF. Let's look at what the new rules will mean using a map of Punjab. And this gives you an idea that if you look at what has happened, you look at the 50 kilometer stretch, that brings you right into towns like Pathankot, Amritsar and Ferozpur. They will all now fall under the BSF's purview. That's the concern in Punjab. So the new rules have triggered a three-cornered fight. The Punjab government versus the center, but also the Congress versus the Congress in Punjab. Chief Minister Charanjit Channi targeted the center, saying the new rules are an attack on federalism. But ex-Congress Chief Minister Amrinder Singh welcomed the rules, saying it will help fight the menace of drugs. The BSF has responded, saying they will only have limited powers.
One is the CRPC, the other is the Passport Entry into India Act, the third is the Passport Act. Only with respect to these three acts, the territorial jurisdiction of BSF has been increased as far as NDPS Act is concerned, Arms Act is concerned, and Customs Act is concerned. The jurisdiction remains the same as before.
Now, I spoke earlier to Congress spokesperson Randeep Surjewala, who tweeted that the chronology of the new rules begins with the massive drug seizures from Adani-controlled ports in BJP-run Gujarat and ends with giving the BSF enhanced jurisdiction in Congress-run Punjab, which he calls an attack on federalism. I began by asking Mr. Surjewala, how does he connect the two, given that the center says this is simply to enhance the war on drugs and terrorism?
Srinivasan ji, the point is rather simple. Bharatiya Janata Party plays politics in every single step they take. What are they trying to do here? For 73 years, the jurisdiction of the BSF in Punjab and many other states across the borders have been 15 kilometers. The idea is Punjab is a small state. Moment you increase the jurisdiction, the federal structure suffers a blow. The state police ceases to have jurisdiction. And tell me, if in the state of Punjab, the elected government of Punjab doesn't have jurisdiction in police affairs over 50% of the state, that is 25,000 kilometers, how will you govern the state? That's the first point. Second point, Government of India is giving a twisted argument now that it is being done to curb the menace of drugs. Please do so by all means. We support it. But tell me, the actual provocation comes where? On 9th of June, from Adani port in Gujarat, 25,000 kgs of heroin worth 1,75,000 crore has gone into the market.
Okay.
Till today, Modi ji or their home ministry have not been able to catch it. On 13th September, they've got 3,000 kgs worth 21,000 crore.
Right. Okay. So
the problem is happening in Gujarat.
Right.
You're taking away powers of Punjab.
Okay.
Why?
You're saying it's the enhanced coverage, 15 kilometers to 50. That's the problem. But Mr. Surjewala, not everybody in your party is on board, because you would have seen the tweets. Mr. Channi, the chief minister, says he condemns this. He says this is a direct attack on federalism. But Captain Amrinder Singh, who, as far as we know, is still very much a leader of the Congress in Punjab, is saying that this is the good step. He's saying BASF's enhanced presence and powers will only make us stronger. Let's not drag Central Armed Forces into politics, says Captain Amrinder.
Well, Srinivasan ji, let us not go into who said what. The only relevant person is Chief Minister of Punjab. Tell me, you take away my 50% of my state,
sure,
the jurisdiction of my police,
right,
almost my entire control, and you don't even decide to discuss the issue with me. Is that the federal cooperation that Prime Minister used to speak about?
It seems to have become a forum where conflicting voices are being raised within your own party, where some actually seem to be defending the move.
Well, I want to only say one thing with a sense of responsibility.
Okay.
And you are one of the most responsible journalists across television spectrum, where there are very few now that I know. Captain Amrinder Singh ji was Chief Minister of Punjab. Why did he not write that increase the limit from 15 to 50 kilometers? He has been Chief Minister for 9.5 years. Did he ever write? No. Because no sane person, no responsible citizen will say democracy and federalism goes. States are mere municipal councils. They would be subjugated to the authoritarian power of the Prime Minister.
Okay.
And if Prime Minister's political party becomes irrelevant,
right,
they will use all means to subjugate the constitutional authority of an elected government.
Okay.
And the problem is happening. See, can I also give you an example?
The limit in
Gujarat was 80 kilometers.
Yes.
Could you catch drugs worth 1,75,000 crore, 25,000 kgs?
Yeah.
Have you been able to catch the aerial vehicles that come in J&K, as also in Punjab and elsewhere, every day?
Well,
and then they are throwing guns, they are throwing drugs. Have we been able to catch?
Did Mr. Channi bring this on himself when he went to meet the Home Minister Amit Shah and said, look, there's a problem at the border, drugs are coming in, you need to take strong action? So in fact, Sunil Jakhar, who's your ex-state Congress president in Punjab, he himself said, Mr. Channi, be careful what you asked for. You may have given away half of Punjab.
The simple thing is, Mr. Charanjit Channi, and I'm saying on your channel with a sense of responsibility, never ask the jurisdiction to be extended or jurisdiction of state of Punjab and its police to be ceded. Is it not rightfully correct for a chief minister to raise concern about problems happening, whether in J&K or on my border in Punjab or elsewhere? Because my border continues to be manned by Government of India, Internal Security Minister is the Home Minister of India. Does it mean that I say, okay, take away all my authority as a state, demolish federal structure, decimate the authority of an elected government, and absolutely impose a virtually authoritarian, autocratic rule and regime in my state,
right,
to the disadvantage of every elected representative? Definitely that's not the intent.
Okay.
Because a chief minister of a border state meets to express his concern,
right,
doesn't mean that you impose an authoritarian rule there.
Okay, but let me ask you in conclusion, Mr. Surjewala, that while you're right to say Punjab as a border state is a sensitive state, isn't it therefore all the more important for all of you to speak in one political voice? The fact that you have the chief minister saying something, Captain Amrinder saying something, Mr. Sunil Jakhar saying something, doesn't that also add to the sense that the ruling regime in Congress in this border state house is not in order? Why hasn't that happened?
Well, I want to reiterate and say, Srinivasan ji, our house is in order. Sometimes personal differences on account of loss or gain of power do happen. Okay. But Punjab is far too important to be mired or to be looked at from the prism of difference between a former CM and the sitting CM. We should honor the unison voice of the Chief Minister of Punjab, spoken on behalf of people of Punjab, and imperative for federal structure across the country. For heaven's sake, don't murder constitutional norms in garb of your opposition to a particular government, Congress government in Punjab.
Okay. All right. Fair enough. Randeep Singh Surjewala, strong words there. Thank you so much indeed for joining us. All right, let me go across live now to Satyapal Jain. He's a senior BJP leader, also additional Solicitor General of India. Thank you very much indeed, Jain Saab, for being on the show. Good to have you as always. Now, the issue seems to be, Satyapal ji, not with the fact that the BSF should have jurisdiction, because it already does. In a state like Punjab, it had 15 kilometers of jurisdiction, but it's a small state. So when you say 50 kilometers, you've brought it in virtually into, as we just saw, we'll put up that graphics again on the map, into virtually half the state. That is what has created such a strong provocation that the Congress is saying this is an attack on the federal system.
See, I'm very sorry to point out that most of the Congress high leaders who are criticizing this notification, with all respect, with all sense of responsibility, humility, I will say, they are showing gross negligence and ignorance of law.
Okay.
No rights of Punjab police have been taken away by this notification. No extra powers have been conferred on the BSF so far as the trial of the cases are concerned. Let me explain you.
Not the extra powers of BSF. It's not that the BSF has got extra powers. The issue is that the BSF, the existing powers of the BSF will now extend all the way into cities, up to cities like Amritsar, Pathankot and so on. Yes.
Let me just explain you what is happening. Earlier, within 15 kilometers of the border, and Punjab border is a very sensitive border, you know, very well.
Yes.
The case of drug finance is going on in Punjab and Haryana High Court.
Absolutely.
There are a number of reports have come in sealed cover and all that.
Absolutely.
All these things are there. Earlier, within 15 kilometers of Pakistan border, the BSF also could arrest any person violation of various sections. Now, this power has been extended from 15 to 50 kilometers.
Yes.
You have seen in Pathankot, Gurdaspur, the drones have been coming right up to 40, 45, 50 kilometers.
Yes.
They have been coming.
Yes.
If you just keep it to 15 kilometers, or the Pakistani smuggler is able to cross 15 kilometers, he enters 16, 17 kilometer, BSF can't do anything.
No, hold on. No. Hey, 1 second.
BSF can,
just a minute.
BSF done is this. BSF will arrest him, search him and all that, hand over to the police.
Yes.
The trial will be by the Punjab police.
Okay.
It is not that Punjab police is ousted.
Few points on that. Understood. Jain Saab, now few points on this. Number one, when you say that there are these terrible incidents, virtually terror instances happening on the soil deep inside Punjab, right? Terror attacks take place all the time, far away from our borders, as we know. They happen in cities, they happen in towns. That doesn't mean that you give central border agencies authority which allows them to act or carry out actions in those cities, right? Then by that virtue, you have to cover the whole state, because you could have a, God forbid, an attack even in a city like Chandigarh. So do you say the BSF can act in Chandigarh? So the issue is that how far is too far? You said 15 kilometers they go, they can go to 16 and escape. We have Mr. Sunil Jakhad, he's coming on the show after you. He said, what if they cross 50 kilometers, go to 51? So the issue becomes, have you given a border force authority which runs too deep into the mainland of a small state? That's the issue.
Mr. Jain, kindly see the Border Security Force Act, BSF Act. Section 139 gives power to the center. This act was not enacted by the BJP government. this act was enacted in 1968, the act says that the powers within the local limits of such area adjoining the borders of India.
Yes.
This act gives power only areas adjoining the border. So you can't make it applicable to Chandigarh or Delhi. For that you have to extend the area
sir,
from 50 kilometers. Please,
50 kilometers. No, no, I know. That's why I'm saying.
50 doesn't come to Chandigarh.
No, no, no. But 50 comes 50. To Amritsar. 50 comes
maybe,
to Pathankot.
Maybe, no problem. Are you concerned with the road distance or kilometer? Or the intention is to curb the menace of the terrorism, the arms which are being smuggled, and the narcotics and all that. The intention should be to curb those things, not whether it is 50 kilometers.
The
or
other argument.
Or 35.
Okay. The other argument which is made. Okay. The other argument which is made, Jain Saab, is also that there have been allegations. There's a question raised about is the BSF the most reliable protector when it comes to the drug menace. There have been allegations that the BSF itself is involved with the trafficking of drugs.
See, so far as the allegations are concerned, the BSF till date is one of the best force which is controlling the entire border and curbing all those things. See, if there is any individual case, that can be against a police officer also, and you have seen that those have been the cases even the against the judges.
Right.
One Delhi judge, High Court was said, doesn't mean the entire judiciary has gone corrupt. There were certain cases of a Calcutta High Court. Please don't go into individual cases. BSF is the best force which is controlling and managing the borders. Powers have been given to them.
Right.
All those who are criticizing now 50 kilometer area, let them point out what are the allegations when the area was only up to 50 kilometers. Did they cross their limits? Did they indulge in corruption? No, nothing of that sort. Congress party has no other issue. They are in frustration, sheer frustration. और वो एक छोटी सी बात 15 से 50 की
ओके सो यू आर सेइंग इट्स अ स्मॉल थिंग
भी खत्म हो गया
ओके
पावर्स भी खत्म हो
गई ओके यू आर सेइंग
इट्स खत्म हो गया
ओके यू आर सेइंग इट्स अ पार्टी विदाउट इश्यूज बट एनीवे ऑल इज गुड
बाकी आपस में कैप्टन साहब कुछ बोल रहे हैं जो 9 साल मुख्यमंत्री रहे 9 साल कांग्रेस के मुख्यमंत्री थे उनको सारा मालूम है
उसी का
सारी जानकारी
उसी उसी पे मैं सवाल पूछ रहा था पहले संदीप सिंह सुरजेवाला से और मैं आगे भी पूछूंगा
सुरजेवाला साहब कह रहे हैं कि doesn't matter, only CM matters. CM to 4 महीने से आए.
All right, I'll have to leave it there. But always great to have you on. Thank you very much indeed, Satyapal Jain, for joining us on the show. I spoke earlier also to Sunil Jakhar. He's been a former state president of the Punjab Congress. And he himself seems to have indicated that this is something that the Chief Minister Channi may have brought upon himself by meeting Amit Shah and thereby opening up the Pandora's box of giving away a substantial chunk of Punjab soil to the center. Let's listen.
Vasuji, I believe you are missing the key word there.
Okay.
What I have also written is unwittingly.
Unwittingly, okay.
Yeah, I think one should grant him this benefit of doubt.
Okay.
He just knew into the position and I think without realizing what he was getting into.
Mm.
He has ended up endorsing this narrative which was being built over the last 4.5 years. I must say, this was being built during our Congress regime, only under Captain Amarinder Singh Ji's leadership, that we have a clear and present danger from across the border.
Right.
But I think nobody within the party or within the state subscribed to it. Me being part of that I never subscribed to this and I thought this was only some kind of, I don't know, whatever the motive might have been. But on the ground, this is far from the truth. There is no such apprehension on the ground. I don't know what is the intelligence input which CM Saab had access to or what access Amit Shah Ji has. But on the ground, there's nothing to indicate that there's any increased threat. Of recent, I think, if you look at his recent tweets, Captain Saab has mentioned about the Afghanistan back of America out of there and this will increase the threat.
Right.
I think it would be foolish on our part, part of India, to underestimate the threat from ISI. Their entire existence of the Pakistan army and their astronomical spending is based upon portraying India as a threat, and to keep that threat perception alive, I think they will always keep creating problems.
Okay. So let me understand what you're saying then. Are you saying that while there may be a threat, there is no need to have gone and taken this decision to give the BSF that much remit of 50 kilometers?
Yes. Yes, yes, precisely. This threat is nothing new, Vasuji, but I'm saying.
Okay, you're saying there's nothing new.
Nothing new. This has been here since 1947.
Okay, but one thing.
It's going to continue.
Okay, but one thing with all respect, Jakhar Sahab, is that this yet again seems to have become an instance where the Congress is speaking in a divided way. Mr. Channi has come out and attacked it. You are also saying that there was no need for this. But Captain Amrinder is defending it. He's saying we're seeing more and more weapons and drugs being pushed by Pak-based terrorists into Punjab. BSF's enhanced presence and powers will only make us stronger.
Let's take Captain Sahab's statement on his face value.
Hmm.
Does that mean that we put our Punjab under central rule? If BSF makes us stronger, then why don't we invite our army? Why don't we put army? I think then we'll be much more stronger. These are issues which we have been tackling all along, sir. Drugs and weapons have been smuggled in all along. That's what I'm saying. Nothing is new.
But then why is Captain Amrinder, who is, as you said, very well aware of all this, why is he now saying
no,
this?
What I have said, Captain Saab is aware of the fact that these are security forces, are like, they are not police, Vasuji.
Hmm.
Their training, their orientation, their mindset is to confront the enemy.
Right.
Not a civilian oppressed or civilian investigation or civilian pursuit. No, right. They are not. What I have said, Captain Saab knows best, that regular or frequent deployment of security forces, whether they are BSF or whether they are ITBP or any other security agency which is put for civilian use, will undermine their morale, their discipline, and even the corruption would creep in. We have seen CRP being affected during the terrorism time.
Okay,
they were deployed here.
Fair enough. But Jakhar Sahab, would you not concede that at a time like this, to have different leaders of the Congress speaking in different voices, doesn't this send out the wrong signal, and doesn't it indicate that your house in Punjab is still not in order?
That's what I said. That unwittingly, Channiji has gone and given some kind of authenticated all this narrative. That's all. That's why I said unwittingly. He has put a stamp of approval. Now, Amit Shahji has a kind of a fig leaf of a reason to say that, come on, you asked from me this strict action. So I've given a strict action. Do you want any more strict action than this?
Okay.
This is what I'm. I have nothing against, but what Channiji has done. But we have given them a lame excuse.
Unwitting. Okay, but I come back to it. On one hand, you have Mr. Channi with his inexperience, as you put it. He may have opened the door to this. On the other hand, you have Captain Amrinder defending it while all of you are opposing it. I'm saying, how much is this internal confusion, divisions, factions within the Congress? How much is it hurting you? You have elections coming up.
It definitely hurts. It is not a matter of hurting Congress party. I think the interest of Punjab, the interest of nation should be paramount. And I think Captain Saab should realize, I don't know when you keep referring to his as internal, because Captain Saab has made no secrets or bones about it that he is planning to leave the party. So he is a leader in transition. So I would not know how would it affect the Congress, but yes, definitely it gives strength to the central efforts to bring in. This is a creeping centralization, creeping dictatorial tendencies, taking over the federal system. That's what I'm saying.
Well, Captain Saab is a leader in transition. Navjot Singh Sidhu is also a leader in transition. That's why.
It's a transitional times these days, but
I'm saying that Congress, of course, national security is interest of Punjab is important, but all this is also hurting you as Congress, as a party.
Yes, I'm more worried about we will come over it is not a problem. The problem is that if this kind of a, Vasuji, it's not just a mere increasing jurisdiction or what difference does it make, whether it was 15 or 40, 15 or 50. But the thing is, if you look at this deployment, increased jurisdiction, you have to see it through the glasses or through the prism of SDM in Karnal saying, sir, phod do inke, I'm here. Mr. Khattar saying, sate satyam samachare, inki dange utha lo. Then we have today Sita Ramanji in Harvard School telling that they are lamenting something is wrong. Instead of acknowledging this arrogance of power is what we are seeing you have to see it in a full context, sir. We can handle any threat from Pakistan. We are not dependent on whether it is 50. And secondly, more important fact which I want to bring.
Yes.
So, what is the scientific method which the Home Ministry or the BSF adopts to determine whether it should be 15 kilometers or 50 kilometers?
Right.
I can understand the principle of hot pursuit.
Right.
But like this is 50 kilometers, so all the drug traffickers and all the terrorists, they will take a refuge somewhere 50 kilometers away from, and then they are free from BSF. Then why not put entire Punjab?
Okay, you're saying your question, the rationale. Let me ask
there is no rationale, sir.
Okay, let me ask you in conclusion though, when you said that Mr. Channi, who perhaps being new to the job may have unwittingly opened this door, given the sensitivities of a state like Punjab where you need leadership who's aware of the issues, do you believe that Mr. Channi then is demonstrating that perhaps he's not fully fit to be able to administer and govern a state like sensitive border state like Punjab?
I think that would be reading too much between the line, Vasuji, but I definitely hope that chair will make the man.
Thank you so much indeed, Sunil ji, for speaking to us. Thanks very much.
Thank you, Vasuji. Thank you.